News section, section break. So anything that you can do to a matrix or to a regular thingy, like a, what do you call it? Anything you can do to a regular variable, you can kinda do to a matrix-ish. it kinda depends, but anything like if, you know, you could be like, if x equals 3, now, okay, and you could be like y equals 4 times x, right? And you're like, yay, that did a thing. I could also be like, okay, well, the matrix equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so, you know, this other matrix equals 4 times a, and it'll totally do that. Now, why am I making matrices capital letters and other variables lowercase letters? No reason at all. And they don't even have to be single letters. They could be ARB, BARK, I can't spell ARB, BARK, and Bohemian, and oops, except. Okay, let me do this, because it's still using the old value of A. I'm gonna start doing something. Every time I start a new section here, see how I'm a new section? I'm gonna CLC clear, which we talked about doing before. Now it says A doesn't exist, which is true. Okay, there we go. So aardvark and bohemian. So anything that I did before, like here, I could say, you know, I could do, thank you. I could do z is equal to the square root of x, and it would be totally happy doing that. Here I could do calibart, whatever that means, is equal to the square root of aardvark, and it can totally do that. Okay, so anything you can do to a regular variable, you can kind of ish do to a matrix. Now, we are going to run into problems where, for example, like, I could be like, I could be like, whatever is equal to x squared, and it's like, okay, and then I'll be like, this other thing is going to be equal to aardvark squared, and this is where things start to go south, okay, and that's where the ish comes from, okay, so everybody's happy, we're all, you know, just doing our thing, and we're like, matrices are great, I love matrices, why would anyone ever not love a matrix? And the answer is, I don't know why they wouldn't, except when you finally get to this, and you're like, why isn't this working? And then you have to remember, wait, math is still math, and if you remember what these things look like in real life, you've got, thank you, let me see, I'm gonna come down here. In real life, you would have a matrix that said, you know, like, insert aardvark, oops, aardvark equals 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, oops, so 4, 5, 6. So if I try to do matrix multiplication, and then, you know, calibart equals A squared, right? So if I was gonna do this in real math, I'm gonna put these in like parentheses or something. Look at all these ways to do things. Oh, I guess I can just write parentheses. There we go. And then I'm gonna square that. Okay, so if I was gonna do that in real math, it would look like this, right? I would be like ka-chunk times ka-chunk. Now, if you remember anything at all about matrix multiplication, you remember that the inner dimensions of the matrices have to be equal to do true matrix multiplication. So the problem here is that you can't do that because this is a 2 by 3, right? A 2 by 3 matrix. So if I try to multiply a 2 by 3 matrix by a 2 by 3 matrix, this is a two, the 3 and the 2 don't match. So again, if I reread this error message, it says, it says incorrect dimensions. So it's basically saying you've got a 2x3 times a 2x3. You can't do that. Now, if I had, for some reason, done this as like 7, 8, 9, and it was a 3x3, it could do that. But I didn't. It's so sad. I should have, you know, not made this mistake on purpose. But I did. So here we are. Okay, so I can't do that. And to be perfectly honest, that's probably not what I wanted to do anyway. Probably what I actually wanted to do, this is what, okay, this is maybe what I wanted to do, but maybe not. But that doesn't make any sense mathematically. And I don't know about you, I don't spend a whole lot of my time thinking in terms of matrix multiplication. Probably, I hate this that it doesn't autocorrect my capitalization. What I really wanted to do was this. What I probably really wanted to do was to have this C and set it equal where each one of these individual values was raised to the square power. Does that make sense? Sort of like that. That's probably in my brain what I was thinking. Because like whenever I said the square root, right? Whenever I said, you know, calibert, I guess when I did calibert, was the square root of C, really what I meant was it was the square root of each one of these little things, right? So that's exactly what it did, is it took the square root of each individual little component. Thank you. So whenever I'm trying to say a squared, it probably meant that what I really wanted to do was square each individual component in the matrix. I didn't actually want to square the matrix. Who in their right mind squares matrices, except for weird old linear algebra professors? So probably what I meant to do was this. I'm going to put this up here. So I'm going to say, do, 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 text. This is what we were doing. Okay, so that line of code did this. There we go. So this did not do what we wanted. This is probably what I wanted to do. Here is how I accomplished this. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to have this other thing, or I guess I'm calling it C now, is aardvark. There we go. Did y'all notice I did that? I started typing aardvark and I can't remember how to spell it, and I never should have created a variable name that I can't spell, but it starts with two A's. I hit tab and then it kind of puts in the rest for me. There's this thing you can do where you can go dot, ka-chonk, squared. Okay? And then you hit go. And then what it's gonna do is it's gonna square each individual element for you. And this is fantastic because essentially it's going to do the element by element multiplication. So the dot whatever thingy, I don't know how else to say it, is the element by element in a matrix. So, you know, like it doesn't make sense to divide matrices. So like, let's just pretend that I have A here and I have like B that's similar, you know, I can just be like, whatever B, as long as they're the same size, you know, I can be like, do, 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 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You know, in real, like in a math class, if I did A divided by B, my linear algebra teacher would punch me in the face, or my algebra 2 teacher in high school probably couldn't punch me in the face. Probably couldn't do this in college anymore either. Take all the fun out of everything. I can't multiply them together, right? Because they don't have the inner dimensions. But probably, again, if what I want, okay? If what I want is to actually multiply them element by element, like if I want it to be like A times B to where it's like, doop-de-doop-de-doo. Like this one is 1 times 2, or 1 times 5, and this one is 2 times 6, and 3 times 7, and 4 times 8. Y'all see where I'm going with this? 5 times 9. I don't know why that did that. 5 times 9 and 6 times 10. Okay, if that's what I actually want, then I can just do that straight up with the code. Is I'll say is going to be A dot times B. Oh, except it's not A, it's aardvark, because I'm an idiot, and it's not B because I never defined it. Did I? No, I'm going to have to call it something. B. B equals 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. And there we go. Those are the values that I'm looking for. So most of the time, whenever you're doing stuff in MATLAB, whenever you're trying to do things like multiplication on a set of data, usually you're going to be doing stuff like element by element. So when you're doing division, so I could also make this a division sign. It's just going to divide the first one by the second one. You could do it times. Now, if you just do plus, you don't need element by element because matrix multiplication. So let's just say try this with plus and minus by themselves because they work. But then also try with dot times. You can try it with dot divide. You can try it with dot caret. And it's pretty cool because they all kind of do different things. Here, I'll do it this way so it's all together because it looks silly now. Now I'm just being silly. There we go. So you can do plus. It just adds them together element by element. But again, that's because that's how linear algebra works. They're all four, exactly four apart. Dot times, dot divide. You know. You can't, I guess you could raise each one to each power in the third, so that would be like, that would be like 1 to the 5th, 2 to the 6th, 3 to the 7th, 4 to the 8th, 5 to the 9th, and 6 to the 10th, so you're getting some pretty crazy numbers there. But really that element by element is the only kind of tricky thing that you might have to do with matrices when you're just trying to do normal, boring stuff. But in general, you can multiply, you can subtract. I didn't actually show you that, but you can just be like, now do all of this and subtract 4, and it'll do that. You can just treat them like variables. The only time you have to be a little bit careful is when you make sure it does the element by element. But aside from that, you know, you should be in totally good shape.